All right, so no Bryce Harper news yet. It's gotta be soon, right? We got Machado, I just need Harper. But today's video, I think we're gonna do something a little fun here. You can tell by the title of the video. We're gonna be taking a look at an article and some pictures that are going to rename the 30 teams in Major League Baseball. Now, of course, these are not actually happening. This is all for fun and games. If you think it's real, well, you gotta reconsider some things. But for those of you who understand that this is not a serious video, this is just some fun, we need something to do on the channel, I'm sure you'll enjoy it. And if you do enjoy it, look at that segue, leave a like on the video, best way to support the channel. Subscribe if you are new and you enjoy the channel and you wanna see more. I want 40K soon, and we are damn close. Make sure you get in that comment section down below, let me know some of your suggestions for new team names. And don't forget to follow me on Twitter and Instagram at DraftNickMark. Links in the description, best way to continue the conversation. Let's go ahead and take a look at this article. So it was written by Michael Clare of Cut4. I'll leave all the links in the description down below. I'll give that guy credit, all that kind of stuff. It was basically talking about how baseball names are so sacred and how it would be fun just to try to change and reinvent a lot of the teams in baseball already. You see this happen in minor league baseball all the time. I think the Buffalo Bison are becoming the Buffalo Wings for a few games. You see this all the time where teams change their names for a few games just for like a little promotion or something like that. So I guess this is kind of along the lines of that, just with major league teams. Of course, not real. So let's go ahead and take a look at some of the logos, which by the way are incredible. I've only looked through a couple of them through thumbnails and stuff like that, but some of these are sick. They're awesome, and we'll just talk about it and have a little conversation. All right, the first one we're looking at is the Arizona Diamondbacks, who become the Arizona Chupacabras. Interesting, not a conventional Major League Baseball team name. I don't think in professional sports we've seen the Chupacabras just yet, but when you look at this logo, it's pretty sick. Now, the Chupacabra is like some mythical creature that like haunts the Southwest area of the United States and Mexico. It's some like historical legend, obviously. It's not real, or it is, I'm not sure about it, but this logo is cool. It uses all the Diamondbacks colors, which I really like. Gets the A incorporated in there. You got a little Chupacabra face towards the bottom. This is a fun little logo. I think the Diamondbacks is definitely the right choice, but I don't know, maybe somewhere down the line, like a minor league team, I could see this. Next up, the Atlanta Braves are becoming the Atlanta Peaches. And honestly, with this one, a little bit disappointed. I'm not a huge fan of this. Now I understand Georgia Peach, Atlanta, the peach tree, all that kind of stuff. But it's just, I mean, I don't know about you, but when you see the peach, you think the peach emoji, and I mean, you can fill in the rest here. But the logo itself, I mean, listen, I have no artistic talent. I can't do this. I can't make a logo like this. But I just, I don't know. I couldn't see this being the primary logo that a team uses. The Atlanta Peaches, while in theory it might have been a good idea, just doesn't come to sense on paper. Baltimore Orioles, moving to the Baltimore Crabs, and I honestly love this logo. I think it's so good. I think it's so clever. So in case you can't tell, you got the B for, of course, Baltimore, but if you look at what it's made out of, you've got crab legs, and it forms to make the B, and it makes the leg. Oh, it's so well done, and of course, Baltimore, Maryland, known for their crabs. And yes, we're talking about the crabs you eat. This is an awesome idea, awesome logo. I love it. Baltimore Crabs, though, maybe not the greatest name, but again, minor league teams should be taking note of this. There's a lot of good ideas here. For the Boston Red Sox, we've got the Boston Scholars, of course. Damn it. I will call you back in a little bit. I'm recording a video. Of course, the Boston area known for having so many different colleges. You got Boston College, BU. Harvard isn't technically Boston. I don't think MIT is either, but it's that same area. So it makes sense with the Boston Scholars. Although this has to be one of the nerdiest names I've ever heard. Who wants to play for a team called the Scholars? That's horrible. Logo, it's all right. The B is a little interesting. It's got the little graduation hat on there. I'll be wearing one of those soon, hopefully. But overall, yeah, no. Boston Scholars, I don't think that they would have a whole lot of fans. That is probably one of the worst names I've ever heard. Chicago Cubs, and they are going to be transformed into the Chicago Goats. As we know, they had the Billy Goat curse forever with the World Series. It took forever. The curse has finally been lifted, but I guess the person making these just wanted to put some salt in the wound that was existing at one point. I mean, it's been closed up a little bit because they did win the World Series in 2016, but you still like to remind them every once in a while. Overall, I kind of like it though. It's a pretty cool looking logo, and Chicago Goats, it doesn't really roll off the tongue. So I think Chicago's better off with being the Cubs. The Chicago Hawks, and let me tell you something, I'm loving this logo. I'm loving the name. Now granted, the name Hawks has been used quite a bit in sports. We got the Atlanta Hawks, technically the Seahawks, but yeah. But I really like it, and I think they're paying a little bit of homage to Hawk Harrelson. I gotta say though, the logo, that is something that would look dope on a t-shirt, or like like even like this, like a little polo right here. That would be a nice looking thing. Now on a hat, I don't know how I would play. Chicago Hawks though, not bad. The Cincinnati Reds are now going to be the Cincinnati Pigs, and let me tell you something, it is a simple logo, but I absolutely love it. From what the article says, that Cincinnati is considered Porkopolis. I've never heard this before. I didn't think it was the pork capital of the world, but if that's the case, this retro style like pig boar type logo, black with the red background, it works so well. Minimalist, but it's so good, it's so clean. I'm a big fan of this logo a lot, and plus you get the Cincinnati C in there. Now the Cleveland Indians are losing a little bit of flair because no more Chief Wahoo, they're just going with the C. They would be coming the Cleveland Rocks, and You know, like that Charlie Brown scene where it's like, what'd you get for Halloween? I got a rock. Yeah, it's kind of how I feel with this. Cleveland is probably one of the most boring cities in the United States I've ever visited. And rocks, well, they're rocks. They're pretty boring. So yes, I get it. The Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, all that kind of stuff with Cleveland. But overall, I mean, logo, I like the C. It's really creative. I think it's a cool looking logo, but Cleveland rocks. It makes sense. Cleveland, boring. You get the gist. Colorado Rockies would become the Colorado Triceratops. And I'm going to give you a little bit of insight here as to why their mascot has been a dinosaur all this time. So during the construction of Coors Field, they actually found a Triceratops fossil when they were digging up the ground. So it makes a lot of sense. It's better than the CR logo than they have, but still. The Rockies with the Rocky Mountains and that purple in there, nothing beats that. Detroit Tigers are becoming, I'm not sure I'm pronouncing this, but let's go ahead with Detroit Nain Rouge. Nain Rouge, they're telling me is French for Red Dwarf. Detroit Tigers is definitely the right name. Interesting character in the middle of this. I do like the logo as a whole, but the Detroit Nain Rouge, that doesn't, I don't think that's gonna stick anytime soon. Houston Astros becoming the Houston Eagles. Again, another team name that's kind of overused in sports, Eagles. It has to do with the space because this was Apollo 11's call sign, which was the Eagle, so that's why they're getting it in there. If you notice, the Eagle itself, the wings and all that, the claws and everything makes up an E. Really creative logo, a little awkward with the Eagle face just kind of like, boop, right in the middle, but definitely well done. Kansas City Royals become the Kansas City Swing, and I'm not gonna lie, a minor league team needs to pick up that name right now. Not necessarily Kansas City, but there needs to be a team somewhere called the Swing. I'm a huge fan of it. I don't know why Kansas City Swing, it just felt right. Logo wise, I understand they got a little bit of music notes in there. You still got the KC, but I think there could have been more. Now I understand it's hard to kind of draw up what swing is. You've got the music, you've got the sport, you know, baseball swinging a bat, and of course the music, like jazz swing music. But the name's great. The logo doesn't get me going. I'm surprised. It's usually the opposite. The Los Angeles Angels drop in Los Angeles, becoming the Orange County Rally Monkeys. Reason they do this is because they actually play in Orange County, not Los Angeles County, despite their name. And of course, we know about the famous Los Angeles Angels Rally Monkey. I love it. This is awesome. Of course, you're not changing the Angels, but this might be one of my favorites. I'm a huge fan. I'd buy Orange County Rally Monkey gear. The Los Angeles Dodgers are becoming the LA Avocados. Not gonna lie, when I look at this, I get the feeling that this is an app for a child. I don't know why. It just gives off the feeling that like a child would be using this and helps them like count or how to read. For a baseball team though, not a huge fan. Gives me a very childish feel, which again, nothing wrong with that. It's just, I don't know, I just see this and it's like, I feel like it's gonna teach me how to do my ABCs or multiplication or something. The Miami Marlins would become the Miami Knights. Of course, building off that amazing branding that they've done with the Miami Heat with the whole Vice theme. Now, yes, the Marlins are kind of getting those colors incorporated now a little bit more, but let's be honest, the Miami Heat Vice jerseys are some of the best in all of sports. So going along with that theme, Miami Knights, all that kind of stuff, the logo, not crazy about it. This is super boring. I think they could have done something so cool for it. But again, thank God this isn't real because that logo's not working for the name. Milwaukee Brewers become Milwaukee Oktoberfest. The name needs some work. The logo, I like, because if you notice, they got the M on top being the foam of the beer, and then the O is the glass. That's just a fantastic looking logo. But the name Milwaukee Oktoberfest? No, that's not good. The Minnesota Twins would become the Minnesota Princes. Of course, Prince, purple for Minnesota, purple rain, all that stuff. You gotta give a little homage to Prince, probably the most famous person to ever come out of Minnesota. And honestly, that logo, it's working. Something's going for me. I think that would be a sick looking logo on a hat, you know, throw it on a black hat. I think that'd look really good. So Minnesota Princes, while, you know, maybe the name doesn't roll off the tongue like it should, I kind of like it. New York Mets would become the Queens Capitals. Capitals, again, another name that's been used already, so I'll try not to punish it too much. I gotta say though, the logo, for those of you who've been to Citi Field and around the Queens area, you would understand what it is. Of course, in 1964, they held the World's Fair in New York, and they gave them like the Unisphere, which is a big thing you see in Queens. So they're kind of incorporating that. It's considered the international capital of the world. Go figure, Queens, New York. Keeping the Mets colors, which of course, I'm a big fan of the blue and orange, but you know, let's keep the Mets. I'm a bigger fan of that. New York Yankees, yeah, New York champions. Come on, really? We're gonna be that on the nose with this? Just rub it in how much better they are than everyone else? I mean, it's fitting because Yankee fans love to talk about how many championships they've won. That's all they seem to say. So I think the name, it's probably perfect for them. The logo, huge fan of it, by the way. It's like in the shape of a trophy. It's got the NYC in there. This one, I hate to say it because it's the Yankees, but this one is one of the best ones that have been done. This is quality. The Oakland Athletics becoming the Oakland Green Beans. Oh, okay. And the logo is just a green bean in the shape of an O. I don't think we need to say too much about this one, but maybe the artist got a little bit bored. Yeah, no, I'm not a huge fan of this one. Okay, so upon further review and reading why he chose the name and the logo for this, he's saying to name it after Billy Bean because he basically is the Oakland A's. So it makes a little bit more sense now. I'll cut him some slack. The Philadelphia Phillies would become the Philadelphia Franklins, of course, after Benjamin Benjamin Franklin. The logo is, of course, the kite with the electric bolt that hit it, and he decided, he figured out electricity? Or he understood electricity? I still don't even really know what he did. You still get the shape of the P, it's keeping the Philly colors, getting a little bit of that light blue in there, which I'm always a fan of. This is one of the better looking logos, of course. Go figure, all the teams I don't like, I'm liking their renamed logos. The Pittsburgh Pirates would become the Pittsburgh Stars, which I'm all about, even though we've seen stars again in team names in the past. But this is a huge shout out to the 70s throwback, the We Are Family jerseys where they had the stars on the hats. I absolutely love those. I think I got that hat when I was younger. Who doesn't love the Pittsburgh Pirates 70s throwbacks? I mean, that... I'd sign up for that. Here I go again. Loving the St. Louis Cardinals. Anything they do, St. Louis Cardinals would become the St. Louis Explorers. St. Louis was considered the gateway to the West as we know. Giving a little shout out to Lewis and Clark who started off their adventure from St. Louis, of course. Got the STL. The T looks like it's a paddle in the boat. This is a great looking logo. I'm a huge fan of this. I love it. Again, Cardinals, something's going right there. Even though they had no impact on this, whoever the artist is, he must have known. The San Diego Padres, who are getting a rebrand next year, some new colors, or some old colors that are becoming new now. Well, the Padres would become the San Diego Surfers. Logo is a little, I'm not crazy about the logo. I like the idea, but overall, it's not a very strong logo. Like, I wouldn't be like, that's a brand I can recognize. But of course, San Diego beach, perfect weather. You got the surf, you got the waves, you got a little SD in there. I get it, but it's not the best. San Francisco Giants would become the San Francisco Cove Dogs. Now, of course, you got the McCovey Cove out in right field, so that's a little bit where you're getting the cove from. But the reasoning for this name is actually pretty cool. I guess when technically Oracle Park now, but AT&T first opened, they were using Portuguese water dogs to go get the balls from the water in right field. That's a cool little history thing that they wove into this new name. The logo itself, it's pretty interesting. I don't think it's my favorite, but it's not bad. The Seattle Mariners would become the Seattle King Salmon. Pacific Northwest, they got all that fish up there. Don't they have like that big market in Seattle that everyone talks about, and they take the fish and they throw them to everybody? It may look nothing like theirs, but I'm definitely getting the minor league team logo feel with this, and you know, it's not bad. It definitely can be a real logo. Just for Major League Baseball, we're a little better than this. Yeah, this might be my favorite. The Tampa Bay Rays would become the Tampa Juice. Obviously, Florida, famous for the Florida Oranges. What a perfect match made in heaven for a team playing in Tropicana Field in Florida to be named after Orange Juice, the Tampa Juice. And the logo itself, fantastic. This is the winner right here, my favorite. Bow down to the Tampa Juice. Texas Rangers become the Texas Cattlemen. I don't think there's a lot to describe here. Texas, farming, cows. The logo though gives me the feel of like that Baby Bell cheese, or what is it, like the Laughing Cow, one of those. I don't remember which one has the cow, but I'm getting the feel of like that cheese with the cow logo. The Toronto Blue Jays would become the Toronto Bats. Supposedly there's a ton of bats that live in Ontario, like 8 different species, so that's kind of why they made them the Bats. I think this is actually a pretty cool logo. It still gets the maple leaf going in there at the top, and you got the bat wings and it makes a T. I don't know why, it just seems like a cheap version of Batman. And then the final team is the Washington Nationals becoming the Washington Cherry Blossoms. And let's be honest, I don't think that there's ever been a team with a less intimidating name than the Washington Cherry Blossoms. Now, while the colors may match what looks like is on my shirt, I don't think it works for a professional Major League Baseball team. Yeah, stick to the Nationals. Cherry Blossoms, I get it. Washington has a lot of Cherry Blossoms. But I don't know if you would get a lot of guys signing for the Cherry Blossoms unless you gave them, you know, $400 million a year. I would love to know your guys' suggestions for new team names in the comment section down below, so give me the best one and I'll pin it. Remember to leave a like on this video if you did enjoy and want to support the channel. Subscribe if you're new and you enjoy the content. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram at DraftNeckMark, links in the description. And you guys know the drill. YouTube recommends you watch this video right here, as well as this my most recent upload, so click through those to help support the channel. Thank you guys for watching. Hopefully Bryce Harper news tomorrow, and I'll see you next time. Bye.